In designing the Salk Institute, Jonas looked to the brilliant architect Lou Kahn to help design a space that would be an inspiration to the scientists that work within. In addition to their beauty, Kahn's buildings are extremely functional for the science that they serve. Each laboratory floor on these buildings is about 65 feet wide by 245 feet long. That is about 16,000 square feet of undifferentiated space, with no structural walls in the interior. These spaces are largely populated by laboratory benches, which are extremely flexible in terms of the science that they provide for. In addition, every other floor in Kahn's buildings is a full height interstitial space. These interstitial spaces provide for heating and air conditioning, plumbing, gas supply, vacuum. They also provide for the electrical needs and the internet connections that serve modern science today. Kahn's design exploits the rich Southern California sunlight. The laboratory spaces themselves are flooded by daylight. All four perimeter walls of the laboratory spaces are open, double-pane glass, creating an environment that's airy and rich with light. Local zoning codes restricted the height of Kahn's building, such that the first two floors had to be placed underground. To accommodate for this, Kahn designed a series of light wells that extend around the perimeter of each building. These light wells are 40 feet deep, 25 feet on the side, and allow daylight to extend down and illuminate the deeper regions of the building. This cathedral for science supports research in neurosciences, plant biology, infectious diseases, cancer, diabetes, and aging, and continues as a modernist masterpiece to facilitate research and new discoveries in those areas.